Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video, you will be learning about how to design centrifugal pump. But before that, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, then click on the subscribe button and also click on the notification bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you will get notified about it. So if you have done that, let us start with our video. So for our topic, our question will be, design a centrifugal pump which has to work for the following condition. That is, the static head idle suction is 2.5 meter, static head at delivery is 15 meter, length of the suction pipe is 6 meter, length of the delivery pipe is 30 meters, actual discharge is 1200 liters per minute, working fluid is water at room temperature. So these are the given data for which we have to design the centrifugal pump. So let us start with the design. The first step in our design is determination of the suction and delivery pipe diameters. So in order to avoid cavitation, we take the value of velocity at suction as 3 meter per second and velocity at discharge as 5 meter per second. After that, we know the formula for the coefficient of discharge, which is Q actual upon Q theoretical, that is actual discharge upon theoretical discharge. We take the value of CD as 0.95. After that, we will convert the Q actual from the liters per minute into meter. We will convert the Q actual from liters per minute to meter cube per second by multiplying the liters per minute by 10 raised to minus 3 upon 16. After that, from this formula, we will calculate the value of Q theoretical, that is theoretical discharge, which comes out to be 0.0211 meter cube per second. After that, moving further, with the help of the continuity equation, we calculate the pipe diameters of the suction and delivery pipe respectively. For this, QTH is equal to AS into VS. This is for the suction pipe diameter. The AS is replaced by pi by 4 DS square into VS. Putting all the required values, we get DS as 0.0946 meter, which is converted into the inches, that which comes out to be 3.78, and after that we rounding off to 4 inches. Again, for the delivery pipe, we use the continuity equation, replacing AD by pi by 4 DD square into VD. Putting all the required values, we get the answer for the delivery pipe diameter as 3 inches. After that, we will calculate the H losses. For this, the formula is HFS plus HFD plus VD square upon 2G plus H pin plus H wall. So for HFS, we have the formula as 4FL LS VS square upon 2G DS. For HFD, 4FLD plus VD square by 2G DD plus VD square upon 2G plus H band plus H wall. Basically, the H band is the loss due to the bend, as we consider as 3 bends, that is 1 bend over here, this is the pump, 2nd over here and 3rd over here. So this we consider as 3 bends, and for the wall we consider 2 wall, one as suction wall and other as delivery wall over here. So we consider as 3 bend and 2 wall. So the loss at each bend we consider as 0.04, and loss at each wall we consider as 0.2. So putting all the required values in this, we get the value of H losses as 7.300 meter. Now we will calculate the manometric head, for which we consider as a static head plus the head loss. The static head is the sum of the static head at suction and sum of the static head at delivery. Putting all the required values, we get the value of manometric head as 24.8 meter. Now, the next step is motor selection. For this, we have for this the overall efficiency is given as by the formula, that is manometric efficiency, mechanical efficiency and volumetric efficiency. The value for each is 0.9 into 0.95 into 0.95 respectively. Multiplying all the values, we get the value of overall efficiency as 0.8122. After that, we have the formula, that is overall efficiency is equal to rho g q hm upon ps. Putting all the required values for it, remember that this q is theoretical discharge. We have to put the value of theoretical discharge over here. So putting all the required values, we get the value of ps, which comes out to be 6.32 kilovat. Now we will go to PSG 5.124. Over there we will select the standard motor, that is 7.5 kilowatt foot mounted running motor running at 2880 RPM. Now we will calculate the specific speed, that is NS. For this the formula is N into under root of QTH upon HM raised to 3/4, which comes out to be 37.64 RPM, which is greater than 10 RPM. So we can say that this pump requires only single stage only. After that, going to our third step, that is design of impeller and blade. So over here, this is D2, D1, DSH and DH. So first we will calculate the impeller diameters, that is interior, that is inside diameter of the impeller, which is D1, which is we consider as equal to DH in order to avoid losses due to the extra fitting. As the DS is 100 mm, so convert it into meter, which is 0.1 meter. After that, we will calculate the velocity, that is U1 by formula, that is pi D1 into N upon 60. Putting all the required values, we get the value of U1. After that, we will calculate the value of U2 from the formula KU under root of 2GHM. For the KU, we take the value as 0.95. Putting all the required values, we get the value of U2 as 20.96 meter per second. After that, from this formula U2 upon pi D2 N upon 60, we will get the value of D2, which comes out to be 0.138 meter. After that, we will draw the IVT and OVT, that is inlet velocity triangle and outlet velocity triangle. After that, from this, we will calculate the value of VF1, which is by the formula KF under root of 2GHM. From this, we will get the value of V1. After that, applying tan theta, and from this and by inversing it, that is theta is equal to tan inverse of VF1 by U1, you will get the value of theta is 10.34 degree, which is less than 30 degree. So always remember that this value should always be less than 30 degree. After that, from this OVT, you will calculate the VW2 by the formula, that is efficiency of manometric efficiency is equal to GHM upon VW2 U2. So putting all the required values, we get the value of VW2 as 12.99 meter per second. After that, we'll apply tan beta, and again inversing it, we get beta is equal to tan inverse in bracket VF2 upon VW2. Putting all the required values, we get the value of beta as 12.04, which is less than 30 degree. After that, again applying the year over year tan for the angle phi, we get theta is equal to tan inverse of bracket VF2 upon U2 minus VW2 bracket close. Putting all the required values, we get the value of phi as 18.81, which is again less than 30 degree. So remember friends that in all this, your angles should be always less than 30 degree. After that, we will calculate the number of plates. For this, the formula is 6.5 bracket open D2 plus T1 upon D2 minus T1 bracket close into sine bracket open theta plus phi upon 2. Putting all the required values, we get the answer as 10.24, which we round off to 11 blades. Now we will assume the thickness of blade at inlet and outlet as 8 mm and 6 mm respectively. Now we have the formula, this formula, that is QTH is equal to pi D1 minus number of blades into T1 bracket close B1 into VF1. Putting all the required values, we get the value of D1. After that, similarly for the value of B2, we will put the value of QTH as same, that is 0.0211 pi value of D2, that is 0.138 minus 11 into T2, that is 6 mm, which you convert into the meters. So we multiplied over here by 10 raised to minus 3 into B2 into 2.75, which is VF2. So from this we will find the value of B2, which comes out to be 21 mm. Moving further out with our design, the fourth step is impeller design of the impeller shaft and bearing design. First, we will do a trial calculation. For the impeller shaft, we will select the material as C45. So the design tau is 45 newton per mm square. So by maximum shear stress theory, we have the formula, which is P is equal to 2 pi n mt upon 16. Putting all the required values, we get the value of mt, which comes out to be 24.86 into 10 raised to 3 newton into mm. After that, with the help of this formula, that is tau is equal to mt upon pi by 16 dsh cube, we will find the value of dsh, which comes out to be 15 mm. From this, we will calculate the value of diameter of hub, that is dh, which is 2 times the diameter of shaft. So the value comes out to be 30 mm. From this DSH, we will also calculate the value of length of hub, which again is 2 times DSH, which comes out to be 30 mm. After that, we assume the thickness of the shroud plate, that is TS1 is 8 mm at crown and TS2 is 6 mm at base. Now we will do the bending analysis of the impeller shaft. For this, W, that is load on the impeller, is WI, that is weight of impeller, plus WC, that is weight of the coupling plus WD, that is dynamic load due to the unbalanced mass. For calculating the weight of the impeller, which is equal to weight of the base of crown, that is W1, weight of hub, that is W2, plus weight of blade, which is W3. So for W1, we have the formula, that is pi by 4 U2 square minus DH square, bracket close, into TS1, rho S into G, plus pi by 4 D2 square minus D1 square, bracket close, TS2 into rho S into G. We can take rho S as 7800 kg per meter cube. So putting all the required values over here, we get the value of W1, which comes out to be 7.6361 Newton. After that, the value of W2 and W3, we take as 0.25% of the W1, so which we get as 1.909 Newton. After we got all the values, that is W1, W2, W3, we can calculate the value of WI, which comes out to be 9.5451 Newton. After that, the weight of the coupling we assume as 25 Newton. After that, for calculating the dynamic load due to the unbalanced mass, we have the formula, which is MI into R2 into omega squared. For the value of MI, we have the formula, that is 0.1 into WI upon G. So putting all the required values, we get the value of MI as 0.0972 kg. And for R2, we take as D2 by 2, which comes out to be 0.069 meter. And for the value of omega, we have the formula, that is 2 pi n upon 60. Putting all the required values, we get the value of omega as 301.59 radian per second. Putting all the required values for the WD, we get the value of WD as 608.60 Newton. Putting all the required values for the WI, WC and WD, we get the value of W as 643.14 Newton. After that, we will see the layout of shaft, which is this. In this, the A is the overhang length and L is the bearing span. So for calculating this A, we have the formula, that is LH plus packing margin. We consider packing margin as 2 times into 50, which is 100, and the value of LH you have found in the previous step, that is 13. So adding this both, we get the value of A, which comes out to be 130 mm. Now the bearing span is, we assume as 2 times A, so the value of L comes out to be 260 mm. After that, for maximum bending moment, that is MB, the formula is W into A. So value of W, which is we have calculated in previous steps, is 643.14 into 10 raised to into 130. So after that, after calculating, we get the answer as 83608.2 Newton mm. After that, for T equivalent, we have the formula, that is under root of MB square plus MT square. Putting the required values, we get the value of T equivalent as 87225.86 Newton mm. After that, we have the formula, that is tau is equal to T equivalent upon pi by 16 dSh cube. So putting all the required values, we get the answer for the DSH, which is 25 mm.
Now we will do the bearing selection. For this, summation of Fy is equal to 0. So Ra plus Rw is equal to, Ra plus Rb is equal to W. Friends, note over here that this is not this correction over some correction over here. This should be R capital A plus R capital B over here. So the value of W is 643.14 Newton, which we have calculated in the previous steps. Now the bending moment about B is taken as 0. So Ra into L plus W into small a is equal to 0. Putting all the required values, we find the value for Ra, which is minus 321.57 Newton. After that, using this value, we will find the value of Rb from this equation, which comes out to be 964.71 Newton. Converting it into kgf, which comes out to be 96.47 kgf. This value is also equal to Fr, which we call as radial load. After that, we calculate the value of P, which is equal to V into Fr into S into Kf. So putting so the value of V we take as 1. The value of Fr we have 96.47. The value for S we take as 1.2, and the value of for Kf we take as 1. So putting all the required values, we get the value of P, which is 1157.764 kgf. Now for L90 mr, we have this formula, that is L90 hr into m into 60 upon 10 raised to 6. For this value of L90 hr, we take as 10,000 hours. We have the value of n, that is 2880 into 60 upon 10 raised to 6. So the value of L90 mr there is 1728 million revolution. After that, we have this formula, that is L90 mr is equal to C upon PE raised to the volt raised to 3. Putting all the required values, we get the value of C as 1389.168 kgf. After that, we will select a suitable bearing such that its diameter should be equal to or more than DSH and C should be greater than C calculated. So we will select the SKF6404 bearing. After that, we will design the volute casing. For this, we are selecting the material GCI40. For this, the sigma UT is 400 Newton per mm. So the design sigma T is equal to sigma UT upon 6, which comes out to be 66.67 Newton per mm square. We will assume the casing of this casing thickness as 20 mm. So we know that volute casing is subjected to circumferential hoop stresses, which is given by sigma T is equal to PD by 2T, where P is the inside pressure in the P is the pressure inside casing. For the form, we have for the calculating P, we have the formula rho G Z. For this, we know the value of a rho, that is 1000 for G, 9.81. And for this value, we are calculating from this equation, that is HM plus VS square plus 2G, putting all the required values, which comes out to be 25.258 meter. Putting this value is also in this, we can calculate the value of for the P. Remember this density is for water, as the substance present in the we are using for the centrifugal pump is water. So this density is for water, that is 1000. After that, we will calculate the design pressure, which is 1.3 times of this P, which comes out to be 3.22 bar. After that, we will find the D equivalent. For this, the formula is D2 plus clearance. We are taking clearance as 20. Putting all the required values, we get the value of D equivalent as 158 mm. After that, we will calculate the sigma T with the help of the values we have found out. And after calculating, we get the sigma T value as 1.27 Newton per mm squared, which is lesser than the design sigma T. So the material we are using is safe. After that, the velocity of fluid at throat will be 30% of the impeller velocity at outlet. So VTH is equal to 0.3 U2 is equal to 0.3 into 20.96 is equal to 6.288 meter per second. After that, QTH is equal to ATH into VTH. We have the value for QTH and also we have the value for VTH. From this, we will calculate the value of DTH, which comes out to be 66 mm. After that, for calculating diameters of casing at different angles, we have this formula: DW is equal to DTH under root of omega is equal to 360 minus theta plus D equivalent. This value of theta we have found in the previous steps, that is 10.34, and the omega is the different angles at which we have to find the diameter, that is at 0 degree, at 60 degree, at 120, 180, 240 and 300. So substituting these values over here, we find the value of DW at a required angle. So this was the complete design of the centrifugal pump. I hope you understand the complete procedure. So if you like this video, then hit the like button, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching. May God bless you.